Hey guys, it's Brant, and I just want to say really quick, I really appreciate you guys watching my videos. Be sure to click subscribe and hit the notification button so you get notifications so you don't miss any content. Also, feel free to leave a thumbs up or leave a comment, and enjoy the video. Hey guys, it's Brant, and I'm back with another Kiss album review, and I'm going to be continuing today in my series talking about the Kiss box set. And today we're going to be talking about the third track on the first disc of the album, which is the first Wicker Lester track that we get to, and it's called Keep Me Waiting. And I do think it's kind of weird that they started the first disc. They said the first disc was started in 66. But they started the album with a Strutter and Deuce. And I don't know why they started the album with Strutter and Deuce. Maybe, you know, because it's not the first song that Gene or Paul ever wrote. But I just think they wanted to start it with songs that fans are familiar to. But after, so I've already reviewed the first track, which is Strutter. I've already reviewed the second track, which is Deuce. The links to those songs are down in the description if you want to check those out. But today we're going to dive a little more into the box set, slow burn our way down into it, and we're going to talk about Kiss's or Wicker Lester's track Keep Me Waiting. So if we open up the box set here, as I've done before, got the book here, and it talks of, not the book, but the piece of paper, and it talks about the next track is Keep Me Waiting, Wicker Lester, previously unreleased. And so if we go into the book here, we're going to fast forward past, but we always stop for the picture. We're going to fast forward past all the stuff and then the beginning, because I talked about that in the first video. If you want to see that, it's in the very first video. And we're going to go here to this nice little spread here, which I really think is really cool, because it's no makeup, Gene and Paul with their porn stashes, and Gene's got those choppers, and it looks like Paul has those choppers too. And so I'm going to put a picture up here of this so you can better see and better follow along with me. The writing for Keep Me Waiting is only about a half a page. So we're just going to go on and read about it, and then we're going to listen to it.
So Keep Me Waiting, it was a Wicker Lester song. It was written by Paul Stanley. Paul plays rhythm guitar, lead vocals. Gene Simmons plays bass and sings vocals. Stephen Cornell played lead guitar. Brooke Ostrander played keyboards. Tony Arzelia played drums. Ronnie Lee Jack played lead guitar. It's produced by Ron Johnson. It was recorded November 14th, 1971 at Electric Lady Studios. It was taken from the unissued Wicker Lester album from 1972. So Paul says, Keep Me Waiting was a song that I wrote before Wicker Lester was together. It was one of the songs that I brought in with Let Me Know and a bunch of others. The guitar line at the beginning and the bass answering was Gene's, which wasn't uncharacteristic for us to do. There were times when one of us might come up with a chord pattern and the other would come in with an instrumental and melody line to complement it. The chord figure that starts Keep Me Waiting and the actual song is all mine, but the interplay of guitars and the bass at the beginning is Gene's. It's funny to listen to this today and hear how I was struggling with a kid's voice and try to sound like a worldly, weary, tough guy. The song still has relevance, however, in the scheme of what it led to. It was one of the songs we recorded for the Wicker Lester album, and like many others, and what started off as a basic rock tune was soon inundated with French horns, choirs, and everything else to insult the senses.
So, going in further into the box set again, we're going to set aside the merchandise catalog. I talk about this in the first episode if you want to see that. I'm going to go back into disc one. And this is going to be track three on disc one. Got that great shot there that I love so much, Paul the Bandit. And I go into details on these on previous episodes if you want to watch CD here. We're going to put it in ye old Crosley CD player and check it out.
Thank you.
Okay, right off the bat, the very introduction of this song, this almost sounds something like Gene would write. It almost sounds like something would have been on Gene's solo album. I kept expecting Gene to start singing, but Paul's going to come in and sing a little bit. Now, I know this isn't typical Kiss, and it's not what we would come to know as typical Kiss. They definitely made a big change in the direction that they were going from Wicked Lester to Kiss in a very short amount of time. But I do like some of the vocal stylings that Paul's doing here. He's got a little bit of Elvis going on there. But when he says, like when he does that, "Baby, behind," the way he kind of screams that and everything, I like some of the vocal stylings that Paul's doing here. Very early Paul vocals. I'm digging it so far. Let's listen to the chorus here. Keep away. Now, if you watch my videos in the past, you know I'm not a big fan of choruses that are just the name of the song repeated over and over with nothing else added. It just feels lazy to me. But, you know, it is what it is on this song. But now Paul said in the thing, in the notes, the liner notes there, talking about the French horns being added. I like the acoustic guitar that you hear in this. It sounds really nice. It's a nice texture. But I'm a big fan of French horns, and so the horns in this don't really bother me so much, and it kind of suits the eclectic, hippie-ish, late 60s, early 70s styling that they've got going on in this song. So I'm digging this so far. It's not Kiss, but I'm digging it. Tell from that clip there, that was the last part of the first verse, the beginning of the chorus, and it's basically just more of the same. It's like a rinse and repeat of the first verse and first chorus. And just before I stopped the CD to make my little comment here, the song is definitely about to take a big turn. So get your hippie pants on, because we're getting ready to ride the hippie roller coaster. Check this out. Holy crap, I kind of like that. I know, right? Weird. Now, oddly enough, I really like that. I like when Paul sings in his lower register like that, when he's saying it doesn't matter what you do or say, I know goodbye is coming anyway. And then Gene comes in that higher, saying, you know, singing along with him. That right there just shows that those guys from a very early point really sounded good together. And I really like that little change there. I know that they're getting ready to go. When they get done with it, they're going to go back in to Keep Me Waiting. But let's see if they surprise me. I really like that little hippie eclectic thing that we went into. And now, you know, the little bridge here that they've done here. I've really enjoyed it. But now let's see where they're going to go from here. I don't want you to do or say. And I was right. I knew they were going to go right back into the chorus, because a verse would have felt really weird here, especially since the second verse they did was basically just a repeat of the first. But I did like that they did that hold. And then, you know, they did that hold. And then they came back, went back into it. But I think from here on out, we're just going to be rinse and repeat on repeating the chorus and then fading out. So let's see. Now, I do like what they did there. If you're going to repeat, if you're going to rinse and repeat and repeat and repeat and repeat the chorus on the way out, at least do something different. And they did that. They did that. Wait and wait and wait. And then they sounds like they brought the horns up a little bit. Brought them more to the front of the mix. But I do like that they did that. But I'm expecting a fade out here. And it was just that. It was a keep, you know, they just did kept repeating, keep me waiting, keep me waiting. And they did it in different, you know, passages and things like that. They brought the guitar solos up. There were some really cool little guitar licks in there. It sounds like they brought whatever ensembles of instruments they had. They kind of brought everything up and kind of swelled it at the end and then just kind of faded it out. So, I actually really like this. And, you know, it's not a Kiss song. It is not. But I could listen to this song again. This is actually, you see a lot of the talent that Gene and Paul and the people around them, you know, like Stephen Cornell, you know, some of the talent that the people around them had. And that is very good production quality. I could see that that was recorded and ready to be released. But, you know, you could definitely tell it was recorded. I have no retrospect on this other than I'd never heard this before until today, until just now. I never heard it. I've listened to a lot of the Wicked Lester stuff, but the stuff that was basically turned out to be Kiss songs like She and stuff like that. And I've listened to stuff like Stanley the Parrot just because, I mean, everybody's heard about Stanley the Parrot and everybody's heard, you know, about Gene's song, My Uncle's a Raft, and everything like that. So I've listened to those just out of curiosity point. But I've never really listened to this one just because I wasn't interested in it. But I really like this. I mean, it's not a Kiss song. It's a Wicked Lester song. But it's actually really good. So I really enjoyed it. So I hope you did too. So I'm going to keep going with these. I don't know what song's going to be next. We'll find out with the next video. I think it's another Wicked Lester song, but like I said, I'm not going ahead of this with you guys. You're hearing it for the first, you're hearing it. Maybe it's not the first time for you, but you're hearing me hearing some of these for the first time as we go through. And I'm not going to go through the whole box set. I had somebody ask me if I'm going to go through the whole box set. I'm really only going to go through the songs that either are demos or maybe live or alternate versions, but if it's just something that's off of a, and I don't know how much of that's on here and how much isn't, like I said, I've not dived into it and I'm not going to. I'm going to go through it. You guys are going to actually be watching me go through it. But anyway, I hope you appreciate this video. I'm Brent and this is In My Head Channel. And if you're a new subscriber and a new watcher, I really appreciate you, as well as my old older, the ones that's been with me since the beginning, I think by the time this airs, I'll probably have been doing my channel for a year, and it's just been a wild ride with my channel the first year, and I'm totally 100% humbled and appreciate every one of you who watch and subscribe. If you've not ever seen me before, and you like what you saw, click subscribe and click the notification button. And I'm Brant. I appreciate you watching. Here's some videos. If you enjoyed this video, you probably might like another one of these others. And if you didn't enjoy this video, well, maybe you'll like one of these others. But I appreciate you watching. Feel free to hit subscribe and click the notifications. Leave a comment. And thanks for watching.